nothing will make you feel more like a mountaineer than climbing a snowy peak with an ice axe in hand. But if you're purchasing your first ice axe, knowing what to look for can be daunting. This video will give you everything you need to know to make sure that next time you head out to the snow-covered mountains, you have the right tool in your hand. The curve of the ice axe will vary depending what the ice axe is for. Climbing axes tend to have a very pronounced curve, which makes it easier for gripping onto rock and ice above your head, but they're less useful for general walking purposes. A typical walking axe will have a straight shaft and will be relatively long to make it easier for using almost like a walking stick in snow and ice environments. And between the two, we have something like this, a general purpose mountaineering axe, which is straight enough to be used to support walking upright, but has enough of a curve that on more technical ground, you can have a bit of a swing with it. Some even have this handhold or hand rest on the shaft, which can be adjusted depending how you want to use it. For the purposes of this video, we'll be mostly looking at your general walking axes and your lightweight mountaineering axe. To work out which length of axe you need, what you need to do is hold the axe by the head in your hand and let it rest down the side of your leg. You want the spike of the axe to come to roughly the top of your boot. But with walking axes, you can get away with a slightly longer shaft, and for climbing axes, slightly shorter is preferable. Anywhere from 55 to 75 centimetres is the norm for a walking axe, whereas climbing and mountaineering axes tend to be at the shorter end at around 50 to 55 centimetres. There are four main components of an ice axe: the pick, the adze, the shaft, and the spike. The pick is the business end of the axe, used for self-arresting and also when climbing, particularly for sticking into ice. More technical axes will have a sharper, more pronounced curve, whereas walking axes tend to have a slightly straighter, less aggressive pick. The adze is this scoop shape at the back of the axe. That's useful for clearing snow off rocks and also for cutting steps in ice when making ascents on snow-covered slopes. The shaft is the bit of the axe that you hold onto. Again, with more technical axes, there may be a grip lower down to support the hand. And you can also buy rubberized tape to cover the handles to make them more comfortable to hold, particularly when it's cold. With a walking axe, the spike on the bottom probably gets most of the use because that's the part of the axe that is plunged into the snow as you're walking with the axe in your hand like a supportive walking stick. For a general walking axe, an all-in-one pick and adze like this is absolutely fine. But with more technical axes, particularly those designed for climbing, the pick and the adze are often replaceable independently. And with some axes, even the spike on the bottom can be replaced. Ice axes are usually given a strength rating of B or T, which is basic or technical. Some are also given a rating of 1 or 2, which again, 1 being the more basic, 2 being more technical. Confusingly, the shaft and the head can be rated separately. For a general purpose walking axe, a type B or type 1 is absolutely fine, whereas for climbing on rougher mixed ground where you may want to use your ice axe as a belay point, you will need the T rated or type 2 technical axes. While it might be tempting to go for the lightest weight axe you can get away with, there are pros and cons of weight with an axe. Yes, a lightweight axe is going to make it much easier when you're carrying it in your pack and also when it's being used as a walking support. But if you're using it in a mountaineering environment where you want to be able to swing the pick and get a good purchase on ice or rock, a bit more weight in the axe is much more useful. A leash is an extra useful addition to an axe to make sure that you don't drop it and see it slide off down a slope. Now, some axes will come with a leash, but those that don't, it's possible to retrofit a leash quite easily. It's not essential to use one, and some people prefer not to, particularly on switching the axe from hand to hand where a leash can get in the way. But if you want to make sure that you don't lose your axe, they are a useful thing to have. Additional features, which are not all that common but are nice to have, are things like this rubber head cover, which make the axe more comfortable to hold in a hand. And also the spike cover like this, which means that your axe isn't going to do any damage to any of your other kit if it's tucked inside a rucksack. Hopefully you now have all the information you need to make that all-important first ice axe purchase. Remember, you can find more gear reviews and advice on livefortheoutdoors.com.